When Allah loves a slave, it doesn't end there. It could end there if Allah will, but no. Now listen to this. This is mind-boggling. This is too much. This hadith is too much. As in, it's so powerful. If you were to reflect on it, you should maybe faint. When Allah loves a slave, He calls on Jibreel. Who's Jibreel? You know who Jibreel is? The greatest of the malaika, as far as Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. The one whom when the Prophet saw, he fainted alayhi salatu wasalam, because of his wings had covered the horizon. Jibreel, the angel who's responsible for the most virtuous thing, which is conveying the revelation from Allah to the messengers of Allah. Jibreel, and what do you know about Jibreel? Allah said, whoever is adu, whoever is an enemy to Jibreel, then Allah is the enemy to the disbelievers. Allah defended Jibreel in the Quran. Jibreel, the one who took the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in Al-Isra Al-Mi'raj, in the ascension to the heavens. Jibreel, the malak, which we don't know what to say about, because of his honor and his virtue in the sight of Allah. Allah will call on him to share with him the love which he has for you. Allah doesn't need to do this. He could not do this, but Allah likes to do this. So he does it. He says, I love Fulan. Now I want you to think that Fulan is you. Whatever your name is, Ahmad, Mayrooq, whatever your name is. Imagine Allah in the above the heavens, above the throne, in His greatness and His majesty, which is beyond our human comprehension, calls out to Jibreel to inform him that He loves you. And then only that. فَأَحِبَّهُ, then He commands Jibreel to love you also. So Jibreel now loves you. Allah and Jibreel love you. But it doesn't end there. Jibreel then will call upon the inhabitants of the Sama. Who are they? All the Malaika. How many? We can't even count. Trillions and trillions of malaika which Allah created beyond our, again, human comprehension. All of them are commanded simultaneously to love you. First Jibreel says, Allah loves Fulan, so now you have to love him. Then all of the angels in the heavens love you. Then Allah will place acceptance for you on earth. So people will love you. Not everyone. You may be saying, why do I have enemies? People who love the Sunnah will love you. The people who love Allah and His Messenger will love you. The people who are upon the correct aqidah and methodology will love you. Other people may hate you because of a problem in them, not because of a problem in you. Because you may say, well, this fasiq, this evil, disobedient person doesn't love me. Don't expect him to love you. He loves people like himself. Who will love you? Righteous people. Righteous people. Well, they don't know why. They don't even know why. You've never even given them a dollar or a rial or a pound. You've never done anything for them. Maybe you scream at them. Maybe you do other things. It's Allah. Why? Because Allah had loved you first. Then Jibreel had loved you first. Then the Malaika loved you afterwards. Then Allah put acceptance for you on earth. So people have no choice but to love you. We ask Allah to make us among them. Now what better than that? What else do you want? What else do you want? What? If you're a person whom Allah loves, in every movement you go, you do, you pray, you sleep, you whatever you do, you are among those whom Allah loves and Jibreel loves and the angel loves, what else do you want, ya akhi? You're guaranteed success in this life and in the life to come. Guaranteed. No way Allah will punish you. No way. No way Allah will punish someone whom He loves.